Welcome back to the Jefferson Exchange. Here's The Creative Way with host Vanessa Finney.
This is The Creative Way on the Jefferson Exchange. I'm Vanessa Finney. In the mid-1990s, a young woman was sitting in class at Stanford Law School when the idea for a parody novel popped into her head. In 2001, her clever story of female empowerment and sisterhood burst onto the scene as both a novel and a movie titled Legally Blonde. The movie garnered 2 Golden Globe nominations, then led to 2 sequels and a Broadway musical. It's currently being performed at Ashland's Oregon Cabaret Theater through September 1st. I recently spoke with the show's director and choreographer, Lauren Blair. So for those who aren't familiar with the story, give us a little synopsis, first of all.
Elle Woods is finishing undergrad, and she's been with her boyfriend for a few years, her boyfriend Warner, and she's thinking that she's going to get engaged, and he says, "We're not getting engaged. I'm going to Harvard Law School on the other side of the country," and breaks her heart. And so she, in an attempt to win him back, she gets herself into Harvard Law School, and she gets out to Boston and finds out that her former boyfriend now has a new girlfriend, and she's sort of lost, and she needs to find her way and figure out who she is, where she fits in the world. And along the way, she makes a lot of really good friends that support her for who she is. And she realizes at the end, I need to take care of myself. This is now my journey. So she learns more about herself. And her journey shifts, and it becomes more about who she is as an individual, not who she is as a partner.
That's true. That is one of the through lines. That's sort of her arc as she grows. And I'm going to play one of the songs from early on in the show just to show her starting point.
Yeah.
Here's the song, Oh My God, You Guys, in Legally Blonde at the Oregon Cabaret Theater.
Now that a man chose you, your life begins today. Make him a happy home. Waste not his hard-earned wage. And so he does not roam. Strive not to look your age. Still it is out of thee. Let it be understood. No man can supersede our sacred bond of sisterhood. Oh my God, oh my God, you guys.
So that starts the show, right?
Yeah, so it's Elle's expectation that she's going to get engaged, and she has her girlfriends help her find the perfect dress, and they're all getting ready for this beautiful night that she thinks will end in a proposal. There is a huge bond of friendship that I love throughout this story. Even when she moves away from LA to Boston, her Delta Nu sisters become a Greek chorus in her mind and support her along the way.
Yeah.
So there's the bonds of womanhood becomes a apparent arc throughout, and they rebuild this, especially at the end, with some of the friends that she makes at Harvard Law as well.
And some surprising friends, as we'll learn.
Exactly.
So another theme is the idea, obviously, of someone being dismissed as unserious based on his or her looks.
Correct.
Does that story ring true for you?
Yeah. It's one of the reasons I was very excited to take this show on, and was 10 years ago and will continue to anytime anyone wants me to. Is yes, I'm naturally blonde and have dealt with some of the things, the assumptions that come with that. Being not serious, being less intelligent, being less reliable, being a little bit easy. So knowing myself and being like, how dare anyone make that preconceived notion based on how I was born, you know, is something that I just want to keep sharing. And I love that this movie turned into a musical, because there's something about adding the dance and the music and the song that boosts the message even more for me. There's this thing that they say, we say in the theater, which is, when you can't say it, you sing it. And when you can't sing it, you dance it. So because it's such a huge dance-heavy musical, I just feel like there's a way to tell so much story through all 3 of those things.
Absolutely. Talk about that. So you're a choreographer as well. So
Correct. What
was your approach? And have you taken any, you know, obviously this is a little different from the Broadway version. It's a much smaller cast.
I don't spend a lot of time watching the Broadway shows when I'm working on a show, because I believe in intellectual property. I believe that the choreographer who did it on Broadway, that was their work with those people. And it's not up to me to copy that. It's up to me to figure out what my work is with my people, mm-hmm. and what makes them look incredible. Obviously, I have seen some clips from the Broadway show. We're doing this show with maybe less than half of the original cast. Most of the time, the jump ropers are at least 15, not 4.
Right.
But that's part of the challenge of working at the Cabaret, is how do we take these really big, fun shows, still do them, but within our capacity.
Yeah.
Within our parameters and our limits.
So the movie was set in the early 2000s, and you chose not to update it to the present day. What was your thinking there?
I chose to keep Legally Blonde in its original time setting, early 2000s, because of how far we have come since then, and I didn't want to do any erasure of the Me Too movement or this world that has occurred in over the past 20 years of women finding more voice. Mm-hmm. I wanted to find her world as it was, so that we can all realize, as patrons, hopefully we're aware enough, and as audience members, to understand how far we've come.
Yes.
And how far there is still to go, because I imagine that there are still, I know that there are still women out there dealing with these challenges, but I think the 23-ish years since that movie was released, so much has already grown, and I want us to be able to recognize that arc.
Right. A reminder to our listeners that this is The Creative Way on the Jefferson Exchange. I'm Vanessa Finney, talking with Lauren Blair, director and choreographer of Legally Blonde, currently running at the Oregon Cabaret Theater in Ashland. So one thing that I noticed when I saw the show is that it is decidedly not just for a female audience. There were men throughout the audience. And not only that, but a couple of, I mean, there's certainly the negative male characters that sort of drive the plot. But there's a couple of male characters that really brought the house down, that people just adored.
Well, in our lives, while we need our female friends and our female colleagues to lift us up, we can't rely on that solely. We need all the people of any gender to build a community, right? To get to the next place, to support you as who you are.
Yes.
So when Elle meets Emmett, and it's not even a romantic thing at the beginning, it's simply, I'm going to help you take the next step and build you up, you know, as
yes.
opposed to make you feel less than.
Yes.
And obviously our villain, Professor Callahan, we always need a villain in mm-hmm. a musical.
Mm-hmm.
But I think even with Callahan, he's just trying to get somewhere. Everyone's trying to get somewhere. And it's who are you going to take along with you and who are you going to try and chop down on your way?
And we do have a clip of that. Here's a clip from the song Chip on My Shoulder,
yeah.
which shows Emmett being supportive. And not only being supportive, but kind of giving her a kick in the pants. So she's complaining that she's, you know, not excelling either academically or romantically there. But part of it she needs to take responsibility for. So he does that.
Correct.
And we don't have the dialogue going into it, but can you kind of set up this scene for us?
Yeah. She has been set up by a fellow classmate who teases her into dressing into a costume at a party where that was not a costume party. So she gets humiliated at this party, and she is stuck outside by herself sitting in a Playboy Bunny outfit. And Emmett, her TA, happens across her, and they begin to discuss how she got there and how he got to law school and finished school. And his story is different than hers. And she realizes that everyone's path is different. And he takes it upon himself to say, if you want to prove yourself, this is what you need to do. You need to study. You need to go to school. You need to show everybody the thing that you're trying to tell everybody rather than just tell them.
Okay. Here's a chip on my shoulder from the current production of Legally Blonde at the Oregon Cabaret Theater.
Though it's hardly my business to say, could it be the real thing in your way? Is the poor guy you're trying to impress?
Yes!
Guess she got a chip on her shoulder. Maybe some wise man told her. With a chance we've been given, we've gotta be driven as hell. She was something to see there. I'm just happy I could be there. First big test and she aced it. She's so close she can taste it. She got a chip on her shoulder.
One of my favorite things about Chip on My Shoulder is her realizing how smart she is.
Yes.
She is smart. She knows this stuff. She is capable. And she just needed someone to say, you can do this. So go and do it.
Right. And by the end, if this isn't giving too much away, she starts realizing that I don't have to change my appearance. You know, she stopped wearing her signature pink to be more serious.
Correct.
You know, there was a somber navy blue.
Correct.
She wanted to dye her hair darker to be more serious. But by the end, she's sort of celebrating, no, I'm smart and cheerful, and I wear pink.
And I wear pink from head to toe.
Yeah.
And that's okay.
Lauren, is there anything that you would like an audience to take away from this show?
The main thing that I would like the audience to take away, one, I want everyone to have fun. We really try to choose very fun summer shows to keep everything bubbly and vibrant.
Check there.
But realizing that we are all our own individuals, and one of the final lines in the show is being true to yourself never goes out of style. And for me, that's been my driving force. The cast has seen me cry 400 times when she sings, that's fine with me, just let me be Legally Blonde. That lyric,
right?
That lyric for me, every single, I mean, I'm tearing up right now because that's where I identify strongly, is just let me be myself, because I still have I have a lot to offer, even though I'm blonde, you know, like.
Right.
So, and yeah, allowing people to be themselves.
So the diabolical female who set her up to go to the costume party that wasn't, in fact, a costume party, so she could be humiliated, eventually comes around to respecting her.
Correct.
So we'll hear a little bit of Legally Blonde remix. This is like the whole company is singing this. So tell us briefly what leads into this.
Vivian is Elle's enemy most of the show. Legally Blonde remix is a culmination of Elle and Vivian's relationship. One of the things we discussed most with the actress playing Vivian is I don't actually think of her as a bad person. I think of her as an insecure person. Mm. And so her actions are more protective than her just being a bad person.
Right. She's undermining because she doesn't feel that she can get ahead otherwise
because
or
she,
be secure.
Exactly. Yeah. And this is the thing that happens. People don't have their own security, will beat other people down to try and boost. And it doesn't happen. It doesn't work. It doesn't fix it. But Vivian witnesses an event with Elle and a professor, and she realizes that Elle is being victimized, and realizing slowly throughout the show that Elle isn't actually competition. Elle could be a really good ally. Like they could be, you know, they could work together.
True. She's not trying to sleep her way to the top. She's being targeted.
Correct.
Yeah.
Yeah. And Vivian had to see it. She has to see it firsthand to understand it. And so this is Vivian seeking Elle out to say, I see you, and I see what happened.
We girls have to stick together. Maybe Warner saw a blonde who was sleeping her way to the top, but all I see is a woman who doesn't have to. I used to pray for the day you'd leave. Soar up and down, you'd be not alone. But when I'm wrong, then I say I'm wrong, and I was wrong about you. So listen up, I see no end.
Disappears into the supply closet in a black coat and comes out in a pink little skirt suit. And she takes herself back to that courtroom and says, I'm going to do this thing. Like, no one's going to tell me that I can't. I'm going to do it my way.
Yeah.
And that's how I would like for everyone to feel. Lead your life the way that you want to. Be a good human. But do it your way. Don't do it anyone else's way.
That was Lauren Blair, director and choreographer of Legally Blonde, playing through September 1st at the Oregon Cabaret Theater in Ashland. You've been listening to The Creative Way on the Jefferson Exchange. I'm Vanessa Finney. You can hear more episodes at jeffexchange.org or wherever you get your podcasts.